The next one's from I don't know. It's just something. Just subject. I don't know who this is from. Something Brown. YouTube response. So you actually asked me to email this to you from the YouTube channel. Phrase it however you like. I don't have the Patreon, so if y'all discuss it, definitely put it up on YouTube for me.
Well, we don't take requests.
I don't know who this is, by the way. Wasn't sure which comment you wanted to discuss either, so included both. Keep up the quality content, and yes, you all need JC. I don't know what this guy's talking about.
We need Jesus.
First response. Did you know what he's talking about?
No, I'm assuming that he must have left some comments on YouTube, and Husey said, hey, if you want a response to that, you have to email the show. So,
okay, so first response. AEW's fan base is a lot younger on average than WWE's. A lot of Meltzer fans are old school, been following them for years. The newsletters and written forms of publications have become more and more obsolete, as are his core fans. In turn, Meltzer realized awfully quickly that he better latch onto the youth movement and change his business model, because those 50-page newsletters aren't doing it anymore. The YouTube sound bites are, though. Kenny Omega is a genius at working a match. I think everybody other than AEW Dick Riders would tell you that was more to do with Okada than Kenny.
Well,
Yeah. Okay, so I don't know what he was referring to. So this guy's an idiot. If you told him to send in a thing that like we're responding to a YouTube page stuff that we haven't read yet, and you're talking about this, you're a moron. Whoever this guy is,
I would
Brown. Let me just read the second response.
The second one, yeah.
This out of context email that I don't even know what he's talking about. Second response. Also, isn't it funny how damn near no AEW spoilers ever get out from Meltzer Bryan, but they yet would tell you what Rollins had for breakfast if you want to know? That's bullshit. All right. This guy obviously cares about stuff that I couldn't care less about, to be honest with you.
I guess.
But,
I mean, do you agree that Meltzer has an AEW bias? Because you see a lot of that on. But why?
Of course. Bro, it's just. Why?
Why? Why?
If you just took an outside person, just any random person, okay, off the streets, okay, and you had a sample size of 1,000 people. They could be sports fans, whatever, and stuff, or whoever they would be. This is all you would have to explain to them, okay? Okay, hey, this guy reports on this show. Two of the show guys on the show named a move after the guy. Do you think he's going to report well on that show?
Yeah.
And it literally is as simple as that.
Okay, let me tell you this.
Okay.
So I know that he's friends with obviously the Young Bucks named that move after him, and he's probably friends with them. He's probably friends with Tony Khan.
Just friends.
Yeah.
They've won the Wrestling Observer Tag Team of the Year for like 5-6 straight years.
Okay, well, there's a couple years. Hey, but they were the best.
They named a move after the guy that has the list.
But they were a good tag team for a lot of those.
I'm aware of that.
To play devil's advocate, Dave doesn't award those awards, though. It's a voting system with other wrestlers and wrestling and all that.
Okay, but let me just tell you, just so you know, because I read The Observer every time I get a chance, and but I read on the computer because I can't stand reading the 50 pages of stuff anymore. So I just read on the computer. I can go through it really quick. And the one thing I can guarantee you, bro, and I can find you. I don't have the time, but if a reader wants to send it to Disco, please do. He will bury AEW on stupid shit or shit he doesn't like. And I've seen it, just so you know.